No, but let's go. Okay, so we want to leave our mark on the world. And being architects, I know you know that more than anyone. I decided a long time ago that my mark was going to be something crazy and big. And I've lived my life by a couple of these quotes, and this is me, but, you know, what we came up with was, want to build a spaceship, but it's not going to fly. And what's the most badass spaceship you've ever seen? It's the Millenium Falcon. So, came up with this idea many, many years ago, had no idea how I was going to do it, but just knew that we had to do it. And when I say we, I'm talking about fans all over the world. When I first saw this thing, you know, when it first appears in the movie, you know, Luke says, "What a piece of junk." And at the exact same time when I was 12 years old and I saw that, I was like, that is not a piece of junk. That is the coolest thing I've ever seen. And someday I'm going to have one of those. And I thought, well, you know, maybe Dad will build me a bunk bed that looks like one, or model or something. So I was like, well, we'll build one. It's got to be easy. It can't be that hard, you know. Well, yeah, right. Started to do the research to figure out, you know, the biggest problem was how big is this thing, because you don't really know. You see it in the film, you know, where's your sense of scale, all of that. So try to figure out how big the thing is. This is gigantic. But we know exactly how big it is now, because back in the 90s, a guy named Robert Brown in Australia did this immense amount of research. I did a ton of research. A friend of mine that I'll introduce here in a minute, in another slide, did some research, and then some Lucasfilm commissioned artists did official research. So now we know how big it is. But the problem is, everything you've seen in the film is either an interior set or a model, neither of which are the appropriate size to fit inside this big outer shell. So we had to figure out, you know, well, that's the size of the cockpit, but how do you get it into the, you know, what's the outside of that supposed to be? Well, when you've seen it, the outside, the model they built, or the set they built in the 70s, was only 80% of what this real scale is supposed to be, and they only built half of it. They built the right-hand half of it. Watch the movie, you'll see. Everything else you see is a painting or something else. And in the 80s, when they redid the movie, it was only 65%, so it was tiny. Watch when you see Chewbacca in the cockpit, he's like this. So I'm a member of this website called the RPF, Replica Prop Forum. They're crazy guys like me that build replicas of movie props. And these guys are insane, and so I got to know them and figure out how insane they were and take advantage of their insanity. And met this guy named Stinson, a college student up in Pennsylvania, who has one of his projects, personal projects, that I'm going to make a perfect 3D model of the inside of the cockpit of the Millennium Falcon. He found me online and said, "Hey, can I work on your project?" I said, "Yes, but you have to do the whole ship." And he said, "Hey, I got nothing else to do." And then, unbeknownst to me, I met this other insane guy in Birmingham who found Stinson's plans online and started building the damn thing without me even knowing it. And then let me know, like, months later, "Hey, I'm making the cockpit for you." So, and there are dozens of guys. So, hey, one day, the BBC calls and says, we read about your spaceship, and we'd like to talk about it. So they flew a guy down to our house who interviewed me and my fiance about building a spaceship. I think today another article came out in the Telegraph in the UK. Yep. So we're building all these pieces, but we got to put it on something. It's got to live on something. And so we are now in the phase of searching for architects. If you know anyone who wants to work on this project and help us figure out how to make this thing actually stand up and not fall down, because we're not building a movie set, we're building an actual building that has to look like a spaceship. We have hundreds and thousands of people all over the world tracking down all the pieces that this thing was actually built out of, like we call them greeblies, like the little detail pieces, and they're the most random things. Toyota or Triumph hubcaps, just random stuff. And there's a guy in the UK who's made it his life mission to track down all these pieces, and he's mailing them to me now. On the models, there's another set of insane guys on the internet who have tracked down all of the original model kits that were used to build the original models that were in the film. And they have this huge database of all of these Japanese motorcycle kits that you have to buy. So we're trying to get everybody together, put together a website where you can get on and figure out who knows who, who's got what, who's doing what. We're selling t-shirts to try to keep the website going, because who knows how many billions of dollars this is going to cost. So feel free to buy one. But a big idea that came out of this is we need a way to manage all of this. So this secondary project that sprung out of this is we need sort of a crowdsourced web app where we can track everything that everybody's building, let people socially share what they're building, you know, their progress, learn from each other. But the first test is we'll build this spaceship out of it, and then maybe we'll build something else. So quickly, the steps for this software product, we need to deconstruct this big model into components. We got to build a catalog of all those components into a database. We got to let everybody be able to get to this thing without having to learn, you know, a CAD program, and then let them share their progress, claim a component as their own, like, hey, I'm building the steering wheel or whatever, you know, watch me do it. And I thought, you know, what better place to build software like that than in our great open source development community that we got here in Nashville. So if there are any software developers who are here, you know, can jump in on that. There's no money to be made in any of this. This is completely volunteer. But I'm also co-chair for the Nashville Mini Maker Faire. We just got approved from Make Magazine in September. We're going to have a real Mini Maker Faire here at the Adventure Science Center. And we will have the cockpit, the satellite dish, and the quad guns from the Millennium Falcon on display at the Mini Maker Faire. So if you want to jump in on the project, I've got some flyers that have the URL. I didn't bring any t-shirts, damn it. This is Morris Stinson's work. He's amazing in SketchUp. Can you imagine? He did all that in SketchUp. Anybody want to help build a spaceship, get in line. We'd love to have you.